when we are so excited to meet you today at the online lesson. My name is Teacher Esther.
I'm Teacher Jane.
Teacher Peter.
Coming to you from
PCEA Nairobi West Sunday School.
Thank you. And now we are going to open our session with a word of prayer. So what do we do when we're about to pray? We put our hands together, we bow our heads, close our eyes, and we are ready to speak to our God. Heavenly and loving Father, we come before you this morning with hearts full of thanksgiving. We thank you and we praise you for all that you have been to us. You have watched over us, you have walked with us, you have provided for us. And dear Heavenly Father, we thank you even for bringing us here today to worship you and to praise you. And now as we sit at your feet to learn in the Bible stories and in the quiz, in the art craft, oh God, everything that we are going to do, may we do it to the glory and honor of your name. Come and be with us and even end with us. In Jesus' name we pray and we give thanks. We all say,
Amen.
Amen and amen. And now, children, let us stand up wherever we are. Let us put our energies and sing this song that says, rejoice in the Lord always. And remember to be happy because we are rejoicing in the Lord. One, two, sing.
Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice.
Thank you, children. We had Teacher Peter running behind us and saying, rejoice, rejoice. Thank you. And now we are going to listen to the Golden Rules.
Hello, boys and girls. I'm here to remind ourselves about Golden Rules. Rule number one, always wash your hand with clean running water, soap, rinse well, and then dry them. Rule number two, do not touch your eyes, your nose, your mouth with dirty hands. Then, rule number three, in case you're sneezing, coughing, you can use a serviette, a handkerchief, or do it at the bend of your elbow. Rule number four, in case you're going outside, remember to put on your face mask, and you put them very well that you cover your nose and your mouth. Rule number five, again, I know now we are at midterm or we have finished. In case you are going outside, always keep a social distance. Don't be too close to one another. Rule number six, and it's also very, very important. If you are not going anywhere, please stay at home. God bless you.
Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to our Bible story section. Today we have a new story lined up for us. Before we listen to our story for today, let's remind ourselves of what we were taught last Sunday. Last Sunday we were taught about how baby Moses was spared by God when he sent a princess to draw him out of the river, and that is how Moses' life was saved. And we see in today's story, which comes from the book of Exodus, from chapter 2 all the way to chapter 4. I know we are ready with our storybook, with our notebooks and our pens and our Bibles. And from the three chapters, we are going to learn about how God spared Moses and sent him to a far country to save, so that he could save the children of Israel. Today's story is about the burning bush, and in that we are going to see how holy God is. So after Moses' life was spared, he fled to a certain country that was called Midian, and it was after he killed an Egyptian. One day when he was outside watching how the Israelites work, he realized that there was a fight between an Egyptian and Israelite. And remember, Moses had learned that he was an Israelite already. And so what happened is that Moses killed this Egyptian and hid his body in the sand. After some days, the king of Egypt, that is the Pharaoh, learned what Moses had done, and he wanted to kill Moses also. So Moses fled Egypt and went to the desert. And when he went to the desert, that place was called Midian, he met a certain family, and from that family he met a girl who was called Zipporah. Zipporah was a Midianite, who was a daughter of a certain priest in that place who was called Jethro. And so when Moses married Zipporah, he became part of that family. And that family owned a number of sheep, and it was in that place that at time when Moses was watching over Jethro's sheep, he happened to take the sheep somewhere in the desert to feed the sheep, to watch them when they were grazing. And it happened that one sheep went astray and it ended up in the Mount of Sinai. And when Moses followed the sheep up in the mountain, something strange happened to Moses. Imagine he saw a burning bush that was not getting destroyed by the fire. And when Moses saw that, of course, what happened? He went near and followed where the flames were coming from. And so when he went to see the burning bush, what amazed him was it was so bright and the light was too much. And when he neared the bush, what happened is that a very loud voice came from within the burning bush, but Moses did not know who was calling out his name. And the voice said, "Moses, Moses." And Moses could not look straight at the burning flames. Why? Because it was so bright. And Moses said, "Yes, Lord, I am here." And when the voice continued talking, it told Moses, "Remove your shoes, for the ground you're standing is holy." And what happened next is that Moses could not even face the flames, the tree that was burning. He hid his face from the bush. And what happened next is that he agreed to remove his shoes because he knew that he was not talking to just an ordinary person and that he was talking to the God who is our creator in heaven. And so when Moses removed the shoes, he went and the voice continued talking to him and told him, "I am the God of your father Abraham, your father Jacob, and your father Isaac. I am the God with whom they worshipped." And then Moses realized that he was talking to our God. And the voice continued saying, "I have seen the way the children of Israel have suffered in the land where they are in, how they have been mistreated by the Egyptians, and I want you to go and save the children of Israel." At first, Moses was afraid, and he told God, "But I don't know how to speak. I would not even know what to say." But God told Moses, "You are not going to say anything from your own self, but I will guide you, and I will help you on what you're going to say." And Moses continued asking God, "But if I go and tell the Pharaoh that you have sent me, who will I say you are?" And God told Moses, "You are going to say, 'I am, have sent you.'" And that is when God told Moses, "Your brother Aaron is on the desert, he's about to meet you, and he's going to help you in whatever you're going to be saying to the Pharaoh, and you're the one who's going to help the children of Israel, and you're going to help them out of the land of slavery." And so Moses agreed to do what the Lord had said, but again, he told him whatever it was that Moses was holding, which was a stick that he was using to watch the goats with, and that is what Moses, God told Moses, "That is what you're going to use to show Pharaoh that I am the one who sent you." And so Moses told, God was told by Moses, "It is time for you to go." Children, what do we learn from the story today? We learn that God is holy. Because when Moses was told by God to remove his shoes, he agreed and obeyed the word of God. So it does not matter where we are, so long as we know and believe in the Lord who created us, we should always have it in our minds that he is a holy God who should be obeyed at all the times. And that brings us to a memory verse for today, children, which comes from the book of Joshua, chapter 1 and verse 5, which says, No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Children, can we take that again? Joshua 1, verse 5, which says, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Until next time, children, may God bless you.
Thank you, Teacher Leah, for that wonderful story about the burning bush. And now we are going to sing a song together that says, God is good, he has done me well, arise and praise the Lord. So together, one, two, sing. God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
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 God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
God is good, he has done me well. Oh my soul, arise and praise the Lord.
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 Hello, boys and girls. Good morning. Welcome to our Bible craft section. Last week, you made some wonderful baskets. The baskets that were reminding us of baby Moses and how he was saved. Today, children, we will be drawing something. It's really, really long since we drew. So today we'll be drawing, and we'll be drawing the burning bush. And this is according to today's lesson. And so what do you need to draw the burning bush? One, you will need to have a white paper. That is an A4 paper. Then you'll also need to have some colors or crayons of different colors, but with a very keen interest with the colors that I have already chosen. That is color green, color brown, color orange, yellow and blue. So it will be now time to draw the burning bush. And so you will pick on color green, then you will begin to draw the spiral lines of the leaves of the bushes. So we'll draw the spiral lines. Spiral lines, spiral lines, spiral lines. You can always use different shades of green. Like now I'm using somehow brighter green. This one is somehow darker. So we have drawn the leaves. Then you can as well color inside the leaves. Color inside the leaves, color inside the leaves. And so once you've done that, it will be now time to put on the stems of the trees or of the bushes. So we are putting on the stems. Remember, I'm using color brown for this. So we'll put on the stems. You can as well add some grass right there. So again, I've just used color green, different shades of color green to add on the grass. Then once you've done that, it will be now time to draw the fire. So we'll use color orange to draw some tongues of fire. Remember, we were told that this bush was burning, but it was not being consumed, or the fire was not consuming the bush. So you continue drawing. Now it's time to use color yellow onto the fire, or to the tongues of fire. Drawing is quite easy. So once you've done that, using color yellow, we'll also put in some details using color blue to show the fire. Color blue, color blue, color blue. And then once you've done that, children, we'll now put some clouds up here. So you can use color blue to just put on the clouds. Nice coloring, nice coloring, nice coloring. Then right up here, you'll write today's lesson, the burning bush. The burning bush. And then right here, you can write your name. My name is Teacher Peter, so I've written Teacher Peter. I am quite sure you like the picture that you have drawn. I am also very happy, and I like the picture that I have drawn. We are always excited to see your work, children. And so here is our finished work. And if you'd want us to see the work that you have done and the picture that you have drawn of the burning bush, please send it to the number that is appearing on the screen. Thank you, and God bless you.
Boys and girls, welcome to our Bible quiz section. Last week, we were supposed to read from the book of Exodus, chapter 1, starting from verse 8 to 16, and Exodus chapter 2, starting from verse 1 to verse 10, and answer the following questions. This week, we are to read from the book of Exodus, chapter 2, chapter 3, and chapter 4, and answer the following questions. Boys and girls, it is always a pleasure to see your work. And even now, if you want us to see your work, please send it to the number that is appearing on the screen right now. We shall mark it and show the results next week. Till then, God bless you. Children, we have come to the end of our service today. We have enjoyed being with you every bit of the way. And now, as we close, we are going to ask Teacher Jane to lead us with a word of prayer. Welcome, Teacher Jane.
Children, let us pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we come beneath your feet, dear Lord, thanking you and even worshiping you, Father, for whom you are. Thank you for being with us since we started, O Father, and even now as we finish, O God, we thank you because you've been with us, O dear Lord. We pray that in our lesson that you chose Moses to work for you, O God, we pray that even as you use us as the noble vessels, Father, to spread your gospel. For this is our prayer of faith in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you, children, for being with us. And now, until next week, God bless you. And remember,
stay safe. Bye-bye.